Can a good scientist also believe in God? Is it possible for a Catholic priest to also engage in serious scientific research? In a previous video, we explored the life and work of Father Georges Lemaître, the Belgian priest and astronomer who proposed the famous Big Bang theory. The example of Father Lemaître by itself flatly refutes the idea argued for by figures like Richard Dawkins, that great scientists do not or cannot believe in God. But is Father Lemaître merely an extraordinary exception to the rule? Are science and faith at odds with each other? The point of this video series is to show that they are not. In fact, Lemaître's dual role as a scientist and priest was not uncommon in centuries past. Even in the modern era, we can find plenty of examples of men who served God as either priests or religious, and who also were pioneers of their scientific disciplines. These figures include Father James McIlwain, a brilliant geophysicist, as well as Brother Guy Consolmagno and the late Father George Coyne, both prominent astronomers who studied the heavens using the most sophisticated tools and theories. Born in 1883, Father McIlwain was ordained to the priesthood in 1918, and soon after graduated from the University of California, Berkeley, with a Ph.D. in physics. His area of research was in seismology, or the study of earthquakes. This consists of measuring the waves that occur on and under the Earth's surface when great blocks of the Earth's crust move, that is, when earthquakes happen. He soon became highly sought after in the spheres of academia, government, and industry. Over the course of his career, Father McIlwain established a chain of seismic recording stations across Central and Northern California and revitalized a network of worldwide Jesuit-run seismic stations called the Jesuit Seismological Service. His efforts helped to establish comprehensive collections of field data used by other scientists. Also a dedicated professor, department chair, and dean, Father McIlwain wrote a renowned textbook on theoretical seismology and helped to create seismology programs for students at Berkeley and St. Louis University. Outside of academia, Father McIlwain's expertise was sought by the U.S. Navy, by several oil exploration companies, and even by the State Department, which chose him to head the American delegation to the International Congress of Geodesy and Geophysics in Rome. For his remarkable contributions to the field, Father McIlwain was elected to the U.S. National Academy of Sciences in 1944, one of the highest honors in American science. He was even elected president of the American Geophysical Union in 1953, a professional and entirely secular organization. He also received the American Geophysical Union's Bowie Prize, its highest scientific medal, among other prizes and recognitions for his work. For a few more examples of extraordinary contributions to science by Catholic priests and religious, let's turn to the Vatican Observatory. Run by priests and religious brothers, the Vatican Observatory is one of the oldest active astronomical observatories in the world, whose roots trace back to 1582. For centuries, scientists and scholars from both religious and secular backgrounds have come from around the world to conduct cutting-edge research in modern astronomy and planetary science. The late Father George Coyne, who served as director of the Vatican Observatory until 2006, oversaw the modernization of the observatory and established the Vatican Observatory Research Group. These efforts led to a collaboration with the University of Arizona on constructing the Vatican Advanced Technology Telescope, a multi-million dollar astronomical research complex with state-of-the-art equipment. He was awarded the prestigious George Van Biesbroek Prize by the American Astronomical Society, the U.S. Organization of Professional Astronomers. The current director of the Vatican Observatory, Brother Guy Consolmagno, is a seasoned researcher and lecturer and an expert in meteorites and asteroids. He has an asteroid named after him, 4597 Consolmagno, and he received the Carl Sagan Medal for Outstanding Science Communication to the Public, awarded by the U.S. Society of Professional Planetary Scientists. He also served as chair of this secular organization, following in the footsteps of Father McIlwain's leadership roles in secular scientific organizations. By their lives, work, and accolades, these incredibly accomplished men refute the very notion of conflict between religious and scientific vocations. Their multifaceted lives, united by a search for truth about the world we live in, show that the answer is most emphatically yes. Good scientists can and do also believe in God. And furthermore, yes, it is entirely possible for Catholic priests and religious to also engage in groundbreaking scientific research. These distinguished careers of Lemaître and McIlwain, plus the Vatican astronomers and thousands upon thousands of scientists, believers, past and present, are the silent testimony that we as human beings are made in the image of God and are made to appreciate the grandeur of His creation through the method and practice of science. For readings, podcasts, and more videos like this, go to Aquinas101.com. While you're there, be sure to sign up for one of our free video courses on Aquinas. And don't forget to like and share with your friends, because it matters what you think.